Hello, fans. I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Indiana State Sycamores and the Michigan State Spartans. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
The matchup in the power forward position should be exciting. Two big men who make great basketball plays on a regular basis.
Tonight we've got two very talented power forwards going head-to-head. Number 44 is the kind of leader a coach loves to have out on the floor.
Starting across from him tonight will be another great player that knows how to run a squad out there. It should be a great matchup throughout the night.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Time for the tip-off. And we're off with a tip here in the first half.
Dumping inside. A little frustration right there.
Now in transition, trying to score the other way.
They come away with a basket off the break. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. The lane. They work the perimeter. He tries the three ball. It's no good. Working it around the perimeter.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
What a great defensive trap there.
10 on the shot clock. Moving it around the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Knocks it down.
What a great touch. Good baseline drive. Squared his body. Well, here comes some pressure.
Goes up for two. Up and in. Receives the ball. Gave it up. And up the lane. Crowder handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. Seconds remaining on the shot clock for two. Up and in. Coach addressing the defense now. Balanced teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
Brad, they like to balance the tempo. They don't feel like they can always play up tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think the style works for them.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Nice hops.
Here comes the ball screen.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He goes with a baby hook.
A lot of hustle. Gave him an opportunity for the second shot.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
As the chance persists.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
With a bucket, no good. And the jam. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Cross court. Way off target. On the outside. Turns it over. Pushes it up.
Pushing that basketball.
The shooting guard receives the pass.
Up and inside!
He launches the bomb. No good from the field. We'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick.
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Pull-up jumper left side. He can't miss.
Hey, this young man's feeling it, Brad.
Trying to feed the low block. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Inside. Ten seconds to get a shot off. Tries for two. The layup. Check this one out, Dick. I think it's a great nominee for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Wow, what a play, Mr. Nessler. That's a young man looking to score. Take it to the basket. A great aggressive move.
A little two-man action. Gave it up. There was no doubt about that one. Vincent receives the ball. The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ten seconds remaining on the shot clock. For two, off the rim and no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Now the turnaround jumper. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Up and in. The shooting guard receives the pass. Tries for two. The lay-in. On the dribble, gives it up. On the shot clock. The missed shot.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude Dunkaroo.
Looking for a good shot. Ten seconds to put it up. Off the mark. Up and in. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Fires away. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
That I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Pass. Goes up for two. The lay-in. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
They work it around the perimeter. Two. The Spartans have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Number 22 gets the ball. Gets up to make the block.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad and Dick, not too many differences between these two players. Seems as though they're almost canceling each other out on the floor. This now could come down to which team is stronger.
Thanks, Aaron. That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. Gilbert handles the pass on the outside. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Gilbert handled, gets the rejection. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Block.
Hey, they're going to have to watch that. Fatigue will make players do some silly things.
Number 32 receives the ball. He unloads.
Up and in.
The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
With a great block. Gave it up. Goes up for two. He'll want that one back. They'll work it around the arc. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Number 22 receives the ball. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the dribble, gives it up. The Spartans have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
The man can't escape.
What a great defensive trap there.
They're working around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet. Fading away, impossible to block.
Looking for a good shot. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Here they go into the break. Cross court. Two. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Vincent handles the pass.
Dump it inside.
For the bucket.
The lane.
Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He's got to get rid of it. Tries for two. In and out. Receives the ball. As the fans continue to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Reed receives the ball. Missed it. Pushes it up. There's the rejection.
Up and in.
You guys got the replay ready up there? Here we go.
They work the perimeter. Unloads. He knocks down another bucket.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. I think they're trying to make a statement. Number 20, he gets his first sweat of the night.
Hey, it's important that this kid gets into the offensive action right away, Brad. He's going to make an instant impact.
Opportunity for 2-for-1. Trying to pack it inside. Balance teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
They feel they are more successful when they focus their attention on doing a bit of both, Brad. They have the personnel to be able to play up-tempo at one end and play in the half court at the other.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. There's a bad pass right to the defender. The shooting guard takes the feed. Moving it around the perimeter. For the bucket.
The layup.
At the end of the first half, the Spartans are trailing by 10. Well, let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. Well, with one half in the books, why don't we revisit those points of emphasis, Dick?
I think they've done an insufficient job so far and do not seem prepared. We covered some important points during the pregame, and I don't think they've achieved any of them. They must do a much better job in the second half.
They've got to do what they do and play their style. Great points there, Mr. Vitale. Let's see how they make out in the second half. Gilbert checks back in.
Hey, yes, sometimes that quick breather can be the difference, Brad.
Dick, in the second half, our player matchup update, and they're playing very, very even right now, and they're not making mistakes.
I tell you what, not making mistakes, and both are doing a great job getting to the free throw line. I think that's been essential in their converting on the line.
Indiana State was on fire in that first half shooting from the field, partner.
I'll tell you, fire's not the word, man. They were blistering, just burning it up. We'll see if they can keep it up in the second half.
Receives the pass. Lots of room. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Bird handles the feed.
Trying to go inside.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up with a shot. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
Goes up for two.
Up and in.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Hey, 10 on the shot clock. This guy's not looking for anybody else out there.
You're right, Brad. He's got a little too much to prove right now.
There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. But if that's your philosophy, so be it.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up with it. Off the mark.
The lay-in.
The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
Ten seconds to get it off.
Pull up jumper from way out.
That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
On the outside. He looks for the bomb. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Gave it up. For two, perfectly executed.
Inside.
They get an open three. He gets the shot to fall. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad.
He can't get any more open than that. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. And the ball goes out of play. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Crowder receives the ball. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Gave it up. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
They look to get it to the inside. He goes up with it. The Spartans have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Look at that spacing.
Jumped in front to take it away. Pushes it up. On the shot clock. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, a two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
He goes to the line for the first time. He gets it to go. Either. They've got him right where they want him, Richard.
Great pass out of the trap, Rod.
on the dribble, gives it up. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
That's a great defensive effort being all over the ball. They get the 5-second call. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Gave it up. Ten seconds on the clock. Trying to feed inside. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Fed the low block.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Up and in. The shooting guard takes the pass. The ball goes out of bounds. Number 22 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Bird receives the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
From downtown. And they don't score there either. Number one takes the pass. For the bucket. Way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. Attempts the jump shot, sticks the deuce.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. What's even more important, they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
I tell you, the jump hook's so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Gilbert handles the feed, tries for two. He puts in another score.
He can see the light, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Gave it up. Ten on the shot clock. He looks for three. Comes up empty. The point guard with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. 10 seconds to get a shot off. Well, whose team tempo will win out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Number 32 gets the pass. For two,
the lay-in.
Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Gave it up. Ten on the shot clock. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Well, let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
Number 31 handles the pass. Well, Dick, we're halfway through the second half of this game. It's in the books now, and what are the stats saying about our marquee player matchup?
I tell you, it's been so balanced and so even. Both kids have really responded to the task at hand, and they really want the ball. That really excites me. They don't run away. They want the ball. Had a little trap really well there, Brad.
Intercepted. Fast break possibility coming.
The offense is having a hard time finding the open look.
Great defense. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
You can't forget about them. The witty humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport.
Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. The shooting guard takes the pass. Looking for a good shot. He puts up the J and come up short. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. But if that's your philosophy, so be it.
They go into the low block for the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Moves not going to work against the defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
They work it around the perimeter. Now on the run. Count that as a personal foul.
Up and in.
Little showtime. It's going to be a three-point play. Got the foul. The bench loves it.
He'll get one shot. No rebounding that. A great trap initiated by the defense. Passes it out of the trap. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it'll come down to in this game.
Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. 10 on the shot clock. On the dribble, gives it up. He takes the open jumper. Knocks down the two. Crowder handles the feed. elbow. They feed down to the low block. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
10 seconds to put up a shot. Gave it up. He shoots from the elbow. Sticks the deuce. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
Number 31 takes the pass on the outside. Strips the ball. The shooting guard gets the pass. For the bucket. Up and in. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Puts up the J. He knocks down the jumper. The center handles the pass. Defense made him keep it too long. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
The small forward receives the pass. On the shot clock. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, you spin back the other way.
With a rejection. That's one of the things I absolutely love about college basketball, Dick, the atmosphere.
They just have to focus, Brad. That's most important, mental toughness.
Robs him of the ball.
Team defense has been stifling, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
You're right. The student sections, the bands, and the crowd are always urging their team to victory, like a sixth man.
Vincent receives the ball. Tries for two. Off the rim and no good. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
The lay-in. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling a tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
Looking for a good shot. Now the turnaround jumper. He pulls down the board. Two. Can't get the shot to go. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Goes up. 10 on the shot clock. Dickey simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
The Spartans are going to call a timeout. And with that, we got a break. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
Talk about a roller coaster ride. You've been on it before. It takes a kind of a special person to be able to call the shots from that sideline.
There are so many highs and lows, Brad. You just hope that you are preaching the right stuff to the kids. You just hope that when you're stressing and asking them to do, they understand and can pull it off.
Up and in.
Timeout charge. Hey, can we get a drum roll, Mr. Nestler? This one's going down to the last ticks, baby.
It up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Dick, we're overtime bound.
I knew this one was going to be one of the great ones, Mr. Nestler. Add extra time to the clock. At the end of regulation, these teams are all even.
Into overtime.
This is when the ballers come to play, baby. Dump it inside.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. The small forward gets the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. Here comes the ball screen. Dumps it in. With the J. Good for two. They work the perimeter. Turnaround jumper. The Spartans have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Braddy's on fire.
The shooting guard with the ball. Gave it up. He unloads a three, and he can't hit the shot. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
Hey, this place is remarkable. The noise is deafening.
Puts up the jumper.
In and out. Ooh. Tough luck.
On the dribble, gives it up. And the ball goes out of bounds. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
The power forward gets the ball. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. For the bucket with the layup. has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The small forward receives the ball. I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
Tries for two with a layup.
Oh my goodness, that was unbelievable, baby!
Working it around the perimeter. Picks off the pass. Transition opportunity coming up.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
The small forward with the ball. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how to dribble use the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the arc.
Vincent handles the feed. And a momentary look from three-point land. He gets the rejection. With great anticipation for the rejection. Perfectly executed. It's a one-point game.
1 point usually means free throws, Brad.
Dumps it in. Just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Shot clock is dead. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. The offense sets up from the sideline. It's down to a 1 point game, Dick.
Yes, sir. This is where the big boys start to play, Brad.
Sideline inbounds. That bucket cuts the lead to one.
I told you there was a lot of time, Brad.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He'll have one and the bonus. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Second shot, no good. Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Dick, really, what goes through a coach's mind during a game like this one?
Well, you know, Brad, if these coaches are anything like me, I'd ask the question, what's not going through their minds? They're thinking about everything, scenarios, special situations, sub-patterns, sets to run, defenses to play. The list goes on and on. I'm sure they're constantly evaluating the tempo of the game and anticipating what's to come.
Ready to start again. Gave it up. goes up for two.
The layup.
Timeout! Hey, these kids are driving me crazy, Brad. This game is too close. I'm starting to sweat, baby. Oh, the pressure.
They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
Puts up a prayer.
He got it for the win. You talk about gutsy and confident. Oh, what a huge shot. Shot of the ball game, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing. He's a BTB-er, a primetime performer. He's big man on campus. What a shot at clutch time. Win, win, and win. Oh, they're dancing with joy.
What are your final thoughts regarding some of our points of emphasis earlier in the game, Dick?
Brad, it's all about solid game plan. Teams who come prepared and know what the important points are will be successful more times than not. Having skilled players on your roster helps, but by no means is it mandatory.
You've got to know your style and play within it. Such an important part of the game. Dick, you know, it's always great to look back and see how the marquee matchup has played out.
Well, that's how you win. You got to execute as a team. You got to make sure the right people shoot the shot. And I'll tell you, the PTBers are responding, but they're responding within a team concept.
Michigan State takes the victory in overtime.
With two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Anderson.